reason soccer dominates the world as it does is the fact that the rules are transparently simple. The pitch is rectangular. The ball is round. You can't use your hands unless you're the goalkeeper. And a game involves 22 foreigners in funny shorts kicking the ball and each other for 90 minutes. After this period, in the normal course of events, the Germans win. The losers riot, and the English slouch off muttering about who won the war anyhow.
The British, of course, weren't even there. But before it began, that sort of cynical comment about the World Cup finals in the United States was pretty typical on both sides of the Atlantic. FIFA, the world governing body, had sold out to the mighty dollar. All that razzmatazz. What did the Americans know about real football? Well, some didn't know and still don't want to know. But those who did helped to produce a championship which, for all the problems for the players, the travel and the climate, a sauna bath in Dallas, a Turkish bath when you went to Orlando, was a real breath of fresh air. The Americans did it their way, of course. The brash and the beautiful went side by side, but only rarely did they look like failing, and only just occasionally did they leave themselves open to accusations of artificiality.
Twenty-four countries, different flags, different cultures, different styles. Nationalistic fervour abounded, but without aggressive feelings for the opposition. The colourful atmosphere set the pattern for the championship. The penalty miss by Diana Ross at the opening ceremony would prove an omen. Other stars would be more successful, and there was stiff competition for top billing. It was a tournament which would touch true tragedy. The wanton killing of Andres Escobar when the Colombians returned home. It would witness, too, a sad end to the turbulent playing career of Diego Maradona, banned for taking a cocktail of drugs. Strict interpretation of the laws was required of the referee, but much depended on who was dealing the cards. Ireland's Englishman was never short of a tale, and neither were his team. The crowd smashed all previous records. The total attendance over 3.5 million, the average per match nearly 69,000. They watched games which, with 3 points for a win, were mostly open, and they helped to lift those that were ordinary. For that, the reward was some stunning goals and that feeling so loved by Americans, I was there. The draw had done the United States few favours, but they made history from the start with the first World Cup match played indoors in the Pontiac Silverdome.
Reggie! Goal! Goal for Switzerland! George Reggie, the veteran, and the hosts are a goal behind. Now the Americans have got a free kick. This is a little bit further out than the Swiss one, but possibilities perhaps. Winalda. Oh, it's in! America have equalised! Eric Winalda, who plays in Germany, brings 77,000 people to life in the Silverdome.
The Colombians were very confident. Pelé said they could win the cup. But as Valderrama met Hadji in Pasadena, the Romanians would feel more at home.
Here's Hadji. Only Radichoiu ahead of him. Here is Radichoiu. Radichoiu! Surprise, surprise! It's Romania who take the lead. Muntianu. Hadji. Oh, it's goal! It's a brilliant goal by Hadji. It's towards Escobar. Oh, it's there!
Great header.
Vital goal from Adolfo Valencia. Hadji trying to find Radichoiu, who's away from the keeper, and has sealed it for Romania.
Who then would have thought that the Swiss, with four hits to Romania's one, would top the charts back in Motown? A great day for the other Englishman involved, Roy Hodgson, the Swiss coach. Back in California, would it be for Uncle Sam as the States met Colombia in the now vital fourth match in the group?
Hodgs looking for Stewart, he's turning into his own goal! The US take the lead with an own goal from Escobar! Ronaldo. Space for Tab Ramos. Here goes Stewart. Keeper committed. Stewart! He scored! The American dream is alive and well. Ernie Stewart makes it 2-0 and they're on their way to the second round.
And the Colombians, though they scored in the last minute and would beat Switzerland, were on their way home, where threats of death made during the competition became sickening reality. For the United States, joy unconfined. They would join the world's best 16 and capture the attention of their fellow Americans on Independence Day, although Romania, winning 1-0, would drop them to third. As ever, no team had more attention, more demands than Brazil. For 24 years of a changing game, the samba had failed to find the right key. With Romario scoring in every group match, there was plenty of excitement among the fans, the critical media included. The first team to qualify for the second phase, they were again labelled the favourites.
No, we are not. The favourites are the Italians, the Germans, the Argentinians, the Hollands. We are not. We're not considered this position. Every World Cup, in the last five ones, we are favourites. Where did you finish? Nowhere. So we are not favourites.
40-1 were the odds on Sweden at the start of the championship. And Martin Dahlin's early form suggested that that was a pretty useful outside bet.
Jonas Tern goes outside him. Here he is. Dahlin! You knew it was coming. Nielsen. Anderson ran diagonally to beat the offside. Dahlin! It's an absolute cracker of a goal.
Lack of money, they hadn't yet been paid for reaching America, undermined Cameroon's challenge. But the officially 42-year-old star of Italia 90, Roger Meir, was still there and would become the World Cup final's oldest scorer. And they found some local support.
What are you going to do if they're drawn against the United States?
Oh, we'll be rooting for Cameroon.
Their team started well enough with a 2-2 draw against Sweden. And a reminder of their own inimitable style of celebration. But they lost 3-0 to Brazil after Song was sent off, and then against Russia, fell apart. For the Russians, already eliminated, there would be a record departure, with the first player to score 5 times in a match.
And again, left exposed, and Selenko has written himself into World Cup history.
The Germans arrived with many old warriors in their ranks. Too many, it was suggested. But at Chicago's Soldier Field, they ended the trend of the holders failing to win the opening match. Jürgen Klinsmann scoring the only goal. Bolivia's Marco Echeverri became the first of 15 in the championship to be shown the red card. He'd been on the field as a substitute for just 4 minutes. When the Spaniards came to the Windy City, Klinsmann found himself as Germany's lone attacker. Not to lose seemed the priority.
This is Goycochea. Caminero and Salinas waiting in the centre. Oh, oh, it's gone in! Oh, it's a goal for Goycochea for Spain! And what on earth was Bodo Ilfner doing? Well, let's see what they can do from the free kick, Germany. Oh, is it in? Klinsmann's claiming it!
South Korea, in the finals for the third time running, deserved a little more luck in USA 94. 2 goals in the last 5 minutes brought them a draw with Spain. They took another point, scoreless with Bolivia. At half-time, they were 3-0 down to Germany, Jürgen Klinsmann scoring twice. Down, but not yet out.
Possibilities here for Hwang Sung-hong. And this time the chance is taken. Cut out by Kohler. Germans pushing up. Oh, a brilliant goal by the captain, Hong Myung-bo. It's delightful for the neutral, but certainly not for the Germans.
And especially not for Stefan Effenberg, who the coach said would not be picked again to the year 2006 after being substituted and then sent home for sign language to the crowd. Spain, beating Bolivia 3-1, with Caminero scoring twice, joined Germany as the group's qualifiers. Winners in Mexico in 1986, runners-up in Italia 90. Argentine supporters were again pinning their faith on the greatest player of his, or maybe any other generation, Diego Armando Maradona. He looked remarkably fit, and against Greece in Boston, the signs were that he had colleagues his presence could inspire.
And the early break now for Argentina, and they got three up and a spare man to the left. Well, that's a good run. Beautiful goal. Batistuta gets his second. All these little intricate one-twos. Maradona! First time he's pulled the trigger, hits the bullseye.
He retired early from the game, allowing Batistuta to complete his hat-trick from the penalty spot. The strutting was now more excessive. but the gods, it seemed, had given him another chance. The same day, in Dallas, the Eagles arrived. From Nigeria, the World Cup had a different beat, as Bulgaria soon found out.
Smell it. It's the glory of the country.
The meeting with Argentina was keenly anticipated, with Maradona equaling the record of appearances in the finals, his 21st match.
And here's Yakini for Nigeria. Oh, and he's got the number 12 in his. It's there! Siasia! Here comes Maradona on the dummy, and this is Batistuta! Caniggia, it's in! It's 2-1.
The new boys apparently put in their place, but the smile of the victor hid a guilty secret about to be exposed.
Both analyses of the urine sample have proved to be positive. The player Diego Maradona of the Argentinian national team has therefore violated the provisions of the doping control regulations in the match Argentina-Nigeria.
As the Argentines at home absorbed the news, Maradona, unrepentant, seemed not to understand.
No. Ormai questo mi ha fatto capire tante cose, no? Che devo andare via subito del calcio, del calcio giocato. Che ormai ho solo la mia famiglia, i miei compagni. Mi ha confermato che dei dirigenti non posso aspettare niente.
How are the mighty fallen? Back in Boston, Bulgaria won a match in the finals at their 18th attempt, beating Greece 4-0. And amid the turmoil of the Maradona affair, qualification in the group would be turned upside down in the final matches. Stadinov, good running here by Stoichko, there's a chance! And he scored! That's a fine goal by Stoichko! Oh! Silico gets a second! Which would have won Bulgaria the group. Had not Amakachi scored even later, the second goal for Nigeria against Greece. Nigeria first, Argentina third, and it seemed the BBC always. Training in the rain was nothing new for the Irish, though it's warmer in Orlando. The manager was trying to dampen things down.
Italy are one of the biggest nations in the world and tremendously gifted, talented players that are recognised throughout the world and are expected to win a World Cup. Ireland are not expected to win a World Cup. Some people say we might, and we might do okay in the World Cup. That's fine, that's all we ask. Who knows? Who knows till on the day?
Well, perhaps the Irish supporters, who somehow had a near monopoly of the seats in New York's Giants Stadium.
Knocked down by Houghton, goes for the shot. It's gone! Ray Houghton! Donadoni. Good run by Dino Baggio. Recovery by Phil Babb, the Italian screaming for a penalty. The referee, very well placed, saw it as a clean tackle. Albertini, almost a good ball in. McGrath's header, Signori. Still Signori, blocked by Bala. Good play by Keane. Coyne pulls back. And it's in the shot. No, it's just good work. And Jack Charlton's Republic of Ireland team have their most memorable victory yet. They have beaten Italy in their opening game of the 1994 World Cup. The Irish have taken over the Big Apple.
Graham, magnificent result.
Yeah, fantastic. Obviously, delighted that we won the game. We always knew we'd be good enough, and I think we proved it today. We should have had a few more. We were a bit disappointed. We never had more than one.
Your goal in the first half, magnificent.
Yeah, we practiced on just taking gambles off Tommy, getting up for headers. Came down, I chested it on and hit it with my left peg of all things, and it went over the keeper's head. And as soon as it went over the keeper's head, I knew it was a goal. So I was ecstatic with that.
An evening of poignant contrasts in New York.
Sir, tell me, what was your reaction when Ireland beat Italy?
Made me sick, very sick. I'm still not over it.
Oppure sei dietro a proteggerlo. Se io ti trovo un'altra volta lì non giochi più fino alla fine.
The Italian media blamed the coach and the goalkeeper, and against Norway things would get worse.
Good ball by Meekland, onside, Leonardsen, and Paliuka saves. With what? The referee goes to his pocket. Will the goalkeeper be sent off? Oh goodness me, a red card. Drama here in New York. And Marco Gianni from Lazio, the most expensive goalkeeper in the world, replaces Paliuka, and they've got to take off an outfield player, Liam.
Well, it's a most incredible decision, John. He's taken Roberto Baggio off. I think Sacchi, with this decision, is gambling his whole career.
He's taking off Roberto Baggio? He is, you know.
There's Signori. A pretty hefty challenge from Haaland.
Oh, Baggio! It's a goal!
Thanks to Dino Baggio, Italy were back on course. The removal of Roberto, Sacchi said, was because of the need for 10 fit men. Temperature and the humidity would be a severe test of Ireland's fitness as they faced Mexico in Orlando.
Bernal.
Away from Phelan. Hermosillo. Shot from Garcia. Luis Garcia with 2 minutes of the first half remaining. And for the first time in these World Cup finals, the Republic of Ireland are behind. Sheridan. Keane. Flip through. Sheridan, onside. Well, it's a good save. But having got into such a very good position, John Sheridan will be a touch disappointed, I think.
It's awkward for Irwin. Garcia Aspe waiting behind him.
Good turn. Garcia. Oh, they gave him shooting space again, and he scored again. And it's a long, long way back for the Republic of Ireland now. John Aldridge here is involved in a bit of a row with an official because he's ready to come on, and he's being prevented from doing so.
And that's what John's got very upset about, and so is Jack.
Aldridge, Sheridan, McAteer. Aldridge!
Not in this match, but vitally in goal difference. Charlton would be fined and banned from the touchline for one match.
Everybody's up in arms about wanting to know about something I don't know anything about. I've not been informed by FIFA yet. I can't find any of the Irish officials because they're all away for it. Everybody's had a day off today, and they're all away to, Disneyland. And, I'll have to wait till I get back and find out exactly what it's all about. I don't know.
He would be anxious in New York, watching from the stands as Ireland, weakened by suspensions, faced Norway. Every team in the group had 3 points.
This is Keane, and Townsend goes again. John Aldridge in the centre. Here's Aldridge! Oh, and it was Henningberg, and it was Sir Lott, and it's gone away. Jakobsen goes again, over comes Babb, brilliant. Houghton, yes. Staunton, yes. Play on, says the linesman on our side. Keane, Kelly in the middle, Renner on the far side. McAteer's there, Sheridan's there too, and there's the chip ball! And it's on the roof of the net! That's it!
0-0 was good enough. The Irish were through. With Mexico and Italy drawing 1-1, goal scored decided, and the odd man out was Norway. Again in New York, the Irish supporters were the ones to seek for good company.
Phil, she's been off and she's
No Ruud Gullit among them, but the faces of the Dutch team were all too familiar to Englishmen. Their introduction to the finals was very much to the point.
Lignon, who likes to hit from distance, has got a great shot on him.
2-1, the win over Saudi Arabia. The overall performance not too convincing. Same score, same feelings, as qualification was achieved against Morocco. In between came the umpteenth meeting with their neighbours from Belgium. Pride at stake, but both expected to go through to the second stage.
Groen has got a flick on, there's a chance for Albert, they score!
The leadership decided, it seemed. But Middle Eastern promise would change all that. Saudi Arabia 1, Belgium 0, was the biggest shock of the first round. And their goal was the best individual effort of the championship.
This is Owairan, a good run, good strong run, still in possession, Owairan, still there! Saudi Arabia, one up against Belgium.
Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, I will show you around.
And here's Rudy Fuller. Finish with style.
Stalin's on this side, Groen ahead of him, and Fuller back, doesn't get it away, Groen, goal! Muller. Back from Klinsmann. Good play by Rudi Völler. Klinsmann takes over and scores. It's an early kickoff here, and some of the defenders are still having breakfast. And another one. And Völler scores his second. Now here's Weber. Well, no, says the referee. Oh, he was a long way back, the Swiss referee. But he had a clear view of it, and the Belgians go to protest. That looked very, very questionable. Albert. That's when the Belgians think about the penalty. The Germans can point to a number of chances they've had, some of them late in the game. Here's Albert. Still Albert! Score! Brilliant goal! Goodness me, he took that so, so well. Final whistle goes, and Germany go through.
Oh, and Hierro's been allowed to go on here and score! Switzerland stopped playing, they thought a player was offside. Sergi. All pushed in, a chance from Luis Enrique, it's two! Luis Enrique, the devastating on the break now. Ferrer is in here, he's been brought down by Pascolo, and that will be a penalty. There are 4 minutes remaining. It's Bagiri Stein. It's 3-0. And what a day for Spain. Anderson, Darlene on the end of it. Kenneth Anderson trying to turn Al-Khelaoui, and he's got round him. Still Anderson, shot was good, 2-0 Sweden. Al-Ghashian made a great run, timed it perfectly. Still there, oh, a super goal, a wonderful goal. Sweden will just want to hold possession and keep it tight and run down the clock. Here's Martin Dahlin, back to Anderson. Kenneth Anderson gets his second of the game, and Sweden's response is immediate.
Ortega plays it through to Batistuta. Play on, says the referee. Little trick by Batistuta on the line. He's given a penalty. He's given a penalty. Batistuta was slightly blocked off on the line. I think it was the number three, Prodan. And Argentina have a penalty kick. 1-1. And the angel Gabriel, as they call him, has bestowed another goal on Argentina. Here comes Hadji. Little ball in. Oh, and a chance and a goal! Dumitrescu again! It's 2-1 Romania. Oh, and for
Aspas. Waldo was the player that got caught, and he's out of the game now, and Romania have got two against one. Selinec coming to the left. This is Dumitrescu. There's a player up on the right. And is this 3-1? It is! It's that inevitable man, Gheorghe Hagi. Here's Chamot. Ortega. Tries to find Batistuta. Caceres. Good effort. Oh, he's cut back off the goalkeeper, and it's 3-2. Balbo has made it 3-2 to give Argentina new hope. And that's it. Argentina are out of the World Cup, and Romania are through to the quarterfinals for the first time.
Can't get to him, it's Bergkamp! It's that man again. Good play by Wim Jonk. Goes for the shot this time. Oh, Pat Bonner! Oh dear, oh dear. The hero 4 years ago makes a sad error. McGrath forward! But the whistle has gone and the goal does not stand. Bergkamp just holds it in the corner. And the referee ends the Ireland story. The Irish team gave all they could, but sadly on the day were beaten by a better side.
In the distance, day was dawning. Comes to me the early morning. Something tells me that I'm going home. Going home, where the summer's coming in, and the moonlight on the river shows.
Finished now, eh? Nice to meet you, lads. I'll see you all again sometime. See you all again sometime, maybe. Who knows? Thanks very much. Thank you.
Hey, 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 at the 4th of July. Hey, 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 at the 4th of July.
Save it, Paul!
strong challenge, strong measures, and a huge blow to the Brazilians, who lose their penetrative left back Leonardo to a moment of madness.
We're 17 minutes away from the first bout of extra time in the tournament. It's 0-0, but it's absorbing. Romario. It's the true. Great chance for Bebeto. He's done it! Brazil take the lead. They've dominated the second half, and even a man down, their class just have to tell. And it's the class of Bebeto, set up by Romario. Actually have a chance of a break here. Romario. Ooh, looked like he was going clear there. Now what's the referee going to make of that? Romario knows what he thinks he should make. Clavijo made the challenge. It's yellow for Clavijo, but it's his second and he's off.
We'll say goodbye. It's Independence Day. It's Independence Day. All boys must go. Going to the Boston Tea Party, going to the party, going to the Boston Tea Party.
Well, they've certainly got height in the penalty area, Nigeria. Amanike scores! And Italy are beginning to run now. Here's Benarivo, the fullback. Zola, now the wide man with Signore off. Surely, well, he was looking for obstruction, but he didn't get it. And now in his anxiety, has put Egwuban down, and it's a red card. And Italy's World Cup is turning to dust. Here's Iacchini to run outside Maldini. Still Iacchini, he dragged him down. This could be another red card. It was a clear, well, it's yellow. And Italy might have been reduced to 9. Officially, 2 minutes left. Musi, Roberto Baggio has equalised. A minute and 45 seconds left of the 90, and finally Roberto Baggio delivers. Now, can they get good service this time from a wide player? Roberto Baggio took it over. Benarivo went down under a challenge. It's a penalty. It's given. Egwuban adjudged to have brought down Benarivo. Baggio has scored off the post. Italy lead 2-1. Number 19 is Emanalo. Nigeria now trying to find a way back into a match, but they looked as if they were going to win. Here's Emanalo. Chance here, Iacchini, away by Dino Baggio. Olise knocks it in. And there's the whistle. Italy are through to the quarterfinals. And Roberto Baggio is their saint and saviour. It's Italy's great escape.
Clear run on goal and finish brilliantly. Luis Garcia had made a forward run. This is Alves Zague. And, the referee, has he given a penalty? Yes, he has. The referee has given a penalty. I don't think that's going to be a very popular decision, except among the Mexicans. Garcia Aspe will take it. And he's equalised. And the referee's gone to show another card. Oh, is that Tremendley F again? He's got to go. That's his second yellow. He's got to go. He was booked in the first half. And Tremendley F is heartbroken.
Well, it's an absolute scandal. I mean, I cannot find words to describe the stupidness of that decision. Ball's knocked down the line. Here he is. All right. The hand goes up slightly, but he anticipated it. Zaga's gone to sleep. The referee's interpretation is an absolute scandal.
Here's Garcia, and Bernal goes in for the header. Now then, another one.
He's already had a yellow card.
He's red again. The referee has sent off another player. Luis Garcia is walking away, and he's been dismissed as well, so it's now one on each side. I mean, those are two of the worst sendings off I think I've ever seen in World Cup football, and I just don't think you can defend the refereeing appointment by FIFA.
It would go on to a penalty competition, with Mexico missing their first three, Mikhailov saving twice. With Bulgaria leading 2-0, Suarez had to score.
And he has scored. Now it's Lechkov, the balding character. He can take his country into a little piece of World Cup history. Yes, he has! Bulgaria go through to the quarterfinals of the World Cup. Campos and Mexico are down and out.
Dino Baggio might think about a shot. Oh, it's a great effort! Wonderful goal! The pace of the match just beginning to pick up a little bit. Under the feet, Caminero! Equaliser! And now over the top of Salinas! Flag stayed down, it would have counted, here's Caminero! Play waved on again, Salinas should have scored. Signore to Roberto Baggio, he'll get there. Baggio, still Baggio, he's gone wide. Baggio produces the magic. Italy lead 2-1.
Sacchi's team through. But what if the referee, later to be given the final, had seen the elbow by Tassotti on Enrique, which on video evidence later brought an 8-match ban? Spain would have had a penalty. Tassotti would have been sent off.
We'll be right back.
Mario is in the middle!
Flag didn't go up, but it looked as though there was an offside. Everybody stopped, and this is Bebeto. And that's the second goal. The Dutch can't believe it. It's Samba type at the Cotton Bowl. Here's Dennis Bergkamp, to whom they look the most. It's goal! Franco would take the free kick that he won. Par again. Oh! Wonderful strike! And Brazil go through to the semi-finals.
God's spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York, these vagabond shoes.
Now here's Berthold, and here's Klinsmann for Germany. Berthold again, and a penalty is given. A penalty is given. Now then, Mr. Matthias. And he scores in the corner. Oh, what's happened on that flank? The Bulgarian player just stopped. It was Kuryakov, and Hessler got into loads of space and set up the play here. And it's going to come back to Voller. The flag's up. The flag's up. It won't count. It's not going to count. Moller had the first shot that came back off the goal frame. Voller put the rebound in, but the linesman was flagging. Germans are prepared to give away a free kick. It was Stoichkov who was fouled in what could be a dangerous position. Stoichkov, yes! Bulgaria have equalised, and they're back in it against the world champions, Germany. Yankov. Lechkov! It's 2-1 Bulgaria. We're already into the third minute of time added on for stoppages, and Germany need to get the ball down the other end of the field if they're going to keep their hold on the World Cup. No, they're not. The holders are out of the World Cup. Bulgaria and Lechkov pull off one of the shocks of recent modern football. 2-1 to Bulgaria.
Be sure to wear some flowers in your hair.
12 minutes remaining. It's milled. It's nicely done. It's Brolin. It's brilliant. Thomas Brolin for Sweden. It's Romania's own time that's ticking away here. It's set up for Hadji. It took a deflection. It's Ramachuriu. It's the equaliser. 2 minutes to spare. Hadji. A bit of space for Dumitrescu. He couldn't make the most of it. It's come again for Ramachuriu. And Ramachuriu has scored again. Dumitrescu, on by Radichoyu. Dumitrescu went tumbling, and Romania have a free kick, and Schwarz has a yellow card. And a yellow card for Schwarz equals a red card. It's his second. And Sweden must somehow try and retrieve this match with 10 men. Anderson calling for the ball again. In he goes with a goalkeeper. He's beaten it to it and equalised!
The penalty competition began with a Swedish miss by Mild. But Ravelli rescued him, saving Romania's fourth from Petrescu. It went to sudden death.
It's Henrik Larsson, the Swedish substitute. Oh! Just slipped into the corner after Prunea made a clear move on his line. Everyone counts now. Miodrag, Belodidic. Ravelli saved it! Sweden are through! Thomas Ravelli has sent his team into the World Cup semi-finals.
So not much between them in the first 20 minutes, but Roberto Baggio now. Roberto Baggio! Albertini and everything at the moment, and Roberto Baggio's through again! Yes! Incredible! Italy have produced 10 minutes of fantasy football. Sirikov. It's a good, oh, it's a brilliant run by Sirikov, and Kostadinov surely, the penalty. Sirikov was brought down as he slid the ball across the goal. Some game. Oh, he rolled it in. He just rolled it in. And Hristo Stoichkov scores his sixth goal of the World Cup. This is Costa Curta. There's an appeal for handball there, and the referee looks very hard at his linesman. He doesn't raise his flag or put it across his chest, and so play goes on.
It does look a handball and looks a penalty.
They're playing on. It's number 15, Conti, looking for Signori. Now they can celebrate. Sacchi has led Italy through to the World Cup final for their fifth time. And this great football-playing nation is jubilant.
Baggio, the orchestrator, left the stage in company with former maestro Luigi Riva. Italy's failure in the semi-final in their own country 4 years earlier had been expunged.
Comes for it, doesn't get it. Here's Romario going for the ball. Brilliant! No, it's not got the line. Amazingly, he's put it wide. Romario cannot believe it. Marcio Santos, just a touch casual. And Jonas Tern has shown the red card. What an extraordinary action by the Swedish captain. A moment of temper that could prove so costly. Jorginho. Romario. Blocked. And
Jorginho on the follow-up, couldn't make it count. Bebeto, Jorginho.
With Thomas Brolin allowed the attacking freedom denied him in the semi-final, Sweden beat the exhausted Bulgarians for third place 4-0, taking the total goals to 1-4-1. But why didn't the Swedes, or even more the Dutch, show greater belief against Brazil? The captains, Dunga and Baresi, led out their teams. The Italian amazingly recovered from a cartilage operation. Memories went back to 1970, Brazil's last victory, and against the same opponents. But injuries and fatigue would take their toll. Pasadena would offer a pale comparison.
Chance of a counter. You know who has the ball. Plays it through to Bebeto. Massaro, they've left a man unmarked, and that man is Baggio. Massaro goes alone, didn't see the player to his right. There's Mazinho, there's Romario, they've given him a bit of space between the two, and he goes for the shot. Good stop. Mauro Silva goes for the shot. His career must have flashed through his mind then. Everything I've done in the past is about to be ruined. Donadoni trying to go outside Blanco. It's a good pullback. Baggio! Roberto with a glimpse of the goal. Zinho. Thought he was pulled. The referee said no. He had a good view. This is Capu, there are three coming onto it, and Paliuka doesn't take it, and gets it in a second time, amazing! How did he get away with that? Got a bit of space here, well! Guided over the top by Taffarel. Back come Brazil again. Mauro Silva. Mazinho, break on the right side, Cafu, inside him, Bebeto. Romario in the area. Romario! No! It's wide! Viola in possession. Good shimmy, Viola! And Romario's gone wide! Great block by Baresi. Nobody there for Brazil. What a wonderful piece of control by Viola. Baggio. Gets it from Baggio! Maldini. And the final whistle goes. The contest between Europe and South America is to go into a penalty competition.
Alternating penalty kick. We'll break the tie.
Oh, and he's missed. And what a nightmare for a great player. Marcio Santos for Brazil. Two shots, two blanks. Albertini, the next for Italy.
Demetrio Albertini of AC Milan. Romario Faria of Barcelona. Oh, what arrogance. It's at 1-1. Goalkeeper move, but it didn't matter. Ivani puts Italy ahead again. Brazilians can't look. Jorginho hangs his head. They're standing all together again. One for all for one. All down up. This moment to Franco, who scores with ease and without power. 2-2. Now Daniel Massaro, called up late to the Italian side after being in the international wilderness for 8 years. Set by Taffarel. So near now, Brazil. The prayers offered. The Brazilian captain with the chance. Who has to score? The man who really has brought the team to the final now has to save them. And it's over the top. Brazil have won the World Cup of 1994.
It was a cruel end for Roberto Baggio, but the right team had won. Carlos Alberto and his players deserved their triumph. Sympathy most for the magnificent Baresi. But after 24 years, Brazil were again the world champions. Collectively, they were short of being a great side. But they had one player touched with genius.
So the 15th World Cup is confined to the record books. America the Beautiful, I think, did well by the beautiful game. In 4 years' time, the flavour will be rather different, rather more Beaujolais than bourbon. But the French will do well to match the Americans. There'll be 32 qualifiers then, so surely there'll be a British challenge to the new holders, once again, Brazil.
Maybe they're friendly.